Hello, I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and welcome to DermTV. No matter how healthy you are, as you get older, you're going to get skin growths. There are lots of different ones, but today I want to discuss the most common type associated with aging, seborrheic keratosis. They're tan to brown colored growths that I'm happy to tell you are benign, non-cancerous, and harmless. So why should you care? I'm going to tell you. Some people start getting seborrheic keratosis in their 20s, some people in their 50s, and once you start getting them, you just make more and more of them. They start as small, tan or brown spots or freckles from a match size to half of an inch. Over time, they very gradually get a little thicker and a little darker. It takes many years. Their surface looks slightly shiny or greasy, as if they had oil on them, and that's where the term seborrhea comes from, because seborrhea means oil or flowing of oil. And they have the name keratosis because keratosis just means a thickening of the upper layer of the skin, especially the normal top layer of dead cells that's almost entirely composed of keratin. They can occur anywhere on the skin, even on the scalp. They are, however, important for three reasons. Number one, because they can be confused with precancerous or cancerous growths, especially melanomas. And when they're confused with melanomas, that causes some people, unfortunately, to have unnecessarily large surgical procedures to remove them. Second, most people don't like the way they look, either because they look like age spots or just because they look unattractive. And number three, occasionally they get broken, torn, or scratched, which may cause bleeding or pain. And once they're broken, they can't be repaired or healed. They just become crusty and more annoying. While seborrheic keratosis can't be fixed, they can very easily be removed by a simple in-office one-minute procedure, which is done with this instrument, which is called a curette. It's almost like a round knife, and with a little bit of local anesthesia, a dermatologist can literally just peel off the keratosis with a rolling, scooping action, peel it right off the surface of the skin. Because they're so common, and older people tend to have so many of them, I try to reassure my keratosis-adorned patients that whoever has the most keratosis when they die wins, because he or she lived to be the oldest, and that always makes them laugh. Please join me again at DermTV.com. If you have a question, please send it to me by visiting DermTV.com/question. I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and thank you for watching today.